great show which has been there for the last 2-3 years, and every year it's been attracting customers who are very, very serious buyers. And I see even during afternoons there are a stream of people coming who are serious buyers, and we at HFC personally feel that this is the right time to invest in properties, particularly in Hyderabad, because given the infrastructure in Hyderabad and given the conditions, the climate conditions, the property prices are very, very competitive as compared to other cities across India. And we at HDFC definitely would assist customers not only in taking housing loans, but would also assist customers in buying properties, would counsel them, we can give them advice on how to approach while buying a property legally, and technically also we can advise them on how to, what to see in the plans and what to see while going through documents and all. And we give a very choice to customers for taking loans. Customers can avail housing loans assistance. Either they can take a fixed rate loan or floating rate loan, or they can take a combination of both fixed rate and floating rate. Suppose they feel that interest rates are going to go up, they can take a part of the housing loan in a fixed rate, and on a part of the housing loan in variable rate also. Processing time can be as low as 1 day, and it all depends on the kind of documents that our customers can give. It can be customized to the requirement of the customers, and it depends. Suppose you have a registration fixed immediately within 1 or 2 days. If you give all the documents, you can do it within half a day, 1 day also. It's not a problem. See, principally the security of the loan will be the property which you are purchasing. The loan will be based on the repaying capacity of the individual. Okay. See, suppose you say they have a security of the property but their income is very less, it will be impossible for the person to repay the loan. So we give loans based on the repaying capacity. We assess based on the monthly repayable income, leaving aside all the other expenses in his family, not entirely depending upon the property. Because if you give loans based on values of property, if he doesn't have monthly repayable income, then it will be a problem for him. Loans are basically up to 80% of the cost of the property will be the loan amount. Okay. And the loan amount depends on the monthly income. Say if ballpark, suppose somebody wants to take a loan of 10 lakhs, his repayment will be, let's say, about 9,500 rupees every month. If he's earning 9,500 rupees every month, we see his income should be around 25,000 rupees. Should be available. So that 1/3 of his income will be towards repayment of loans. The balance 2/3, he has to have his other expenses in his family and all other, PF and IT deductions and all that.